our safety investigator with the, National Transportation Safety Board. First of all, let me extend my condolences to the family and friends of those loved ones that were involved in this event. All right, there's been an outpour of sentiment provided by the community, which just shows, goes on to show me that they were truly integrated in with this, with the community. And this is just a, such a tragic event. So please let me express my condolences to those family, and we're going to try to do everything, you know, everything within our abilities to try to, trace down exactly kind of what happened with the with this event. I would also like to extend my gratitude to the first responders out there providing support for this event. They have been an exceptional team, and some of those first responders, and I know I'm going to leave somebody out on this, so please forgive me if I miss anybody out on this. The Monterey Regional Fire Department, they've been out there pretty much since the start of the event. The Sheriff's Department, the Monterey Sheriff's Department, has also been out there since the start of this event. The San Jose FAA has been out during the start of this event. The airport staff has been exceptional. They've been coordinating a lot of our efforts. They've been just getting to know the local community. They're definitely plugged in with the local community here. So let's talk about what we currently know right now. So the investigative process is a just like anything else, it's going to be a process to go to try to gather as much data as possible through the entire event. We are currently in the fact-finding process of this event. Okay, so what do we know at this event? So yesterday, at about 10:40, a multi-engine Cessna airplane departed from the Monterey Airport. The tail number on that was November 678 Sierra Whiskey. They took off. They departed from the from runway 10 right. They departed. They made a climbing right turn. At the time of the departure, there was another aircraft that was landing, and they noticed that the cloud layer was roughly about, the tops were right around 2,000 feet, and the bases of the cloud layer was between 700 to 800 feet. The aircraft continued making a climbing right turn and climbed to about 1,900 feet. ATC then noticed that they were actually going towards terrain. ATC then provided a low altitude alert, and they also provided vectors. The aircraft then continued making the right turn, but it also started to descend where it impacted the southwest corner of a residence. Luckily for the residents, there was nobody home at the time, and there was no pets also that were there during that time frame. There was a post-crash fire that ensued. So the fire department ended up extinguishing the fire. The sheriff's department has maintained security throughout the entire event. The team on scene has been phenomenal. I cannot express my gratitude towards the support that's been provided by the community and also the first responders going out there. We're going to continue to gather data. I'm currently in the process of documenting the scene. And going through and photo documenting the scene, collecting evidence along with our partners, the first responders that have provided assistance. All the data that is currently in the process of being captured will then essentially contribute or help towards developing what's considered a probable cause. Now, the probable cause will eventually lead us to hopefully preventing future accidents such as this tragic event. And that's essentially the end goal of the NTSB, is to try to prevent future accidents in the aviation community. So with that being said, that's currently what we currently have right now. So let me take a couple questions, and I'll start from my right side over here. Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, that is absolutely correct. I'm not confirming any names. It's the coroner's responsibility, so I'm not even going to start to tread in those waters. Okay. So I'm going to leave that to them.
Can you confirm there was a passenger?
We currently know that it is being reported that there was two persons on board during the takeoff. So that's currently what we know as of right now. Ma'am. That is actually part of the data gathering phase. We are trying to essentially gather as much information as we can to try to establish that. And that will be later on in the analysis portion. And right now it's too early to tell why the aircraft descended. Over on the right side, left side?
Are you considering some weather issue?
Sir, that, you know, that's a great question. The gentleman on my left is asking if there's any weather issues. Right now, what we observed, of course, with the landing aircraft was the cloud tops were roughly right around 2,000 feet, and the bases were right around 700 to 800 feet. So the altitude that the aircraft was in was right around 1,900 feet. Weather issues, we don't know at this time. That's where it's going to be a further on process to try to gather more data to try to figure out exactly if there was a potential weather issue. And I'll take one more. Yes, ma'am.
Can you tell us anything about the owner of the plane? You have the tail numbers, so do you have anything about the background of the plane's owner?
That is actually part of our process. We're actually going to be attempting to try to gather the maintenance records, talk to anybody that's actually done any kind of maintenance work on the aircraft to try to establish any kind of history of the aircraft. Aside from it being a Cessna multi-engine airplane, right now I really can't expand anything else on that. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to say thank you for your time. Please understand that I've got to go get back out to the site so this way I can continue working on the actual accident scene. Like I said, I will let you keep you guys all abreast as far as whether or not we're going to be doing another press brief. So again, thank you for your time.
Really quickly, where are you going to stage in the piece of the plane that you're covering?
That's a great question. And I actually kind of forgot to kind of talk about that. Yes, the aircraft is going to be recovered to a secure facility so we can go forward and process the aircraft, do aircraft layouts, and do a more extensive exam of the airframe.
So I had a question regarding that debris field. There's a debris field, and it looks like there's an engine that this plane may have fallen apart before crashing into the home. Any indication that something happened?
Okay, last question. Right now, it's way too early to tell if the aircraft, essentially based off what you're asking is, did the aircraft fall apart before it hit the house? So right now, it's way too early to determine that. And that's what part of the process of gathering all that data. So this way we can do a more extensive analysis of the aircraft when it is secured. Okay, folks, again, thank you for your time. Enjoy the rest of your day.